Hello. Hello.
What can I say, man?
I could not believe it. Yeah, I couldn't believe it. Not in my wildest dream.
I guess I really started cranking when I was 14. I guess I just never thought it was that big of a deal.
I didn't witness the actual event, but I was there for the fallout. I had to console Sam and Jane.
It was right around my birthday. I'm a Cancer, so I just thought, hey, this is a day to celebrate me, as it were.
The case in question was a real turning point for me. I mean, I've cranked in bigger venues before, but never like that.
As someone who wears fleece, I can't really get behind what James did.
Yeah. Oh, don't. I wake up some nights sweating with visions of what I saw that day.
Hard time thinking about it now. It's been a while, but it's kind of hurt that just never goes away.
Oh, don't. Sorry.
I do suffer from survivor's guilt. I think we all do. It's bonded us.
Normally, people who wear fleece are more chaste, so I wouldn't do that.
It was just a lot.
It was a lot for me.
I'd never done one before quite like this.
I mean, my washroom was defiled.
I told myself I was gonna do it. I wasn't about to back down. I was excited. The thrill, the smell, the friendly confines of that washroom.
It was a lot. It was so much.
I found myself a magazine, selected a photograph,
when Sam and I walked into the bathroom, I was obviously shocked because I was seeing someone in a pretty vulnerable position, but I wasn't shocked overall. It did seem like something that he would do, like kind of like a Ted Bundy sort of thing. Like you could tell there was something sinister underneath.
One thing they don't tell you about trauma is that it comes in waves. So there was the initial shock and horror. But it follows you.
When we opened the door, he was wearing two pairs of underwear. That was something that was shocking to me because he already seemed like kind of an exhibitionist, so you'd think that almost maybe he'd wear no underwear. But he had two pairs on. And I think about that a lot. Still, today.
I think when you experience trauma like that, you need to lean on somebody, and Jane and I just found each other.
Oh yeah, totally.
We were both suffering from the same trauma.
Completely casual.
She was like a scared little field mouse, and I was a slightly bigger field mouse.
Yeah, completely. Oh, don't. No, don't kiss it. Don't. That's a rental.
Sir?
Sorry.
Stop. Sorry. Thank you. I regret not knocking. I'll regret it forever. Because what we saw in there is burned into my memory.
We all wonder what would have happened if I had opened the door, if I had been the one standing between Jane and Sam and that horrific scene.
And the sound of it, I'll never forget. Not to be vulgar, but it was kind of like,
but it's just like what Cher said, you know, if I could turn back time, then I would do that. I would turn back time. I would find a way.
Never had my bathroom defiled like that.
I really don't like Sean.
Yeah, they weren't really friends.
I just keep flashing back to it.
I really don't like Sean.
I thought it was okay, but quieter, and the kind of quiet where you kind of know there's something brewing underneath.
I can't unsee it.
I really can't let it go. It was truly disgusting.
I really do not like Sean and his stupid fucking glasses.
It's the kind of behavior that you would just never expect from a Pisces.
The sunglasses. Who wears them indoors? There's no prescription.
Now I have to relive it over and over and over.
I'm a different person now. I just have to do this.
No, don't.
Different person now.
I didn't know that's what this is for.
Yeah, I would not like that.
I thought this was about the lingering trauma caused by having James masturbate in my washroom.
No.
I'm a different person now.
But yeah, okay, yeah, I guess I can go see him. Sure. Hey, man. Oh.
Everything's all by the I still love you.
I still love you.
You don't know what it's to